Trigonometric Integrals, Level 6. In the previous video, we covered four distinct cases of trigonometric integrals whose integrand contain powers of sine and cosine. Specifically, integrals of the form sine raised to the power of m of x times cosine raised to the power of n of x dx. It is important to note that all the integrals from the previous five videos contain the same expression inside the argument of the trigonometric function. In other words, both sine and cosine contain the same angle inside the argument. At times, the process of reducing integrals in which both the powers on sine and cosine are even tends to produce products of sine and cosine whose arguments are different. When you're face to face with products of sine and cosine of the form sine of mx times cosine of nx dx and sine of mx times sine of nx dx and cosine of mx times cosine of nx dx, you want to make use of the following product to sum identities. 1 half times the quantity sine of a minus b plus sine of a plus b and 1 half times the quantity cosine of a minus b minus cosine of a plus b and 1 half times the quantity cosine of a minus b plus cosine of a plus b, respectively. These same expressions can be written in terms of the constants m and n as follows. By making use of these identities, we can reduce the products of sine and cosine into sums of sine and cosine, whose integral is relatively easier to find. Before we go over some examples, I want you to notice a couple of things. First, notice that these identities can only be applied when both sine and cosine are linear functions. In other words, the highest degree or exponent of the trigonometric functions has to equal 1. Second, the product sine times cosine is not the only combination that can potentially have distinct angles. Products of sine and cosine can also occur. So be on the lookout for products with the same trigonometric functions, but whose arguments contain distinct angles. With that said, let's go over the first example. Find the integral of sine of 5x times sine of 7x dx. Notice that both trigonometric functions are linear, meaning they have a degree of 1. Their order is equal to 1. In addition, they contain distinct arguments, or in this case, distinct angles. One is 5x and the other is 7x. It is very important that you are able to spot these distinctions. You really don't want to find the integral by using the techniques from the previous video. They will most likely lead you nowhere. The only exception is that you can actually solve this integral by using integration by parts. If you want a challenge, I invite you to try this integral by using integration by parts. This integral can be solved a lot easier by using the following product to sum identities. Remember, there are three different identities, depending on what combination of trigonometric functions we have. In this case, we have sine times sine. They also contain different arguments. This means that we need to make use of the following product to sum identity. With this identity, products of sines can be written into sums of cosines. For this integral, a is equal to 5x, and b is equal to 7x. So we go ahead and subtract the angles on the first expression, and add the angles in the second expression. Doing that, we obtain the following. Next, we go ahead and factor out the constant 1 half. Notice that we now have a sum and or difference of trigonometric functions. Now we can find the integral term by term. The integral of the first expression requires a u substitution, which results in the following integral. The second expression also requires a u substitution, which results in the following integral. Then we make sure we include the constant c. The final step is to distribute the constant 1 half. Doing that, we obtain the final answer equal to sine of 2x over 4 minus sine of 12x over 24 plus c. These integrals are relatively easier than the integrals from the previous videos. The only hard part was to make sure we identify when we need to use the product to sum identities. Alright, let's try the next example. Find the integral of cosine of 4x times cosine of 9x dx. Once again, notice that we have products of trigonometric functions of degree 1. The highest exponent on each function is equal to 1. In addition, both functions contain different expressions inside their respective arguments. One is 4x, and the other one is 9x. This means that we need to use a product to some identity. Notice that this integral contains a product of cosines. So we need to make use of the following product to some identity. Notice that this identity looks similar to the previous product to some identity. Both expressions contain cosines, and the arguments are also the same. The only distinction is that this one contains a sum, and the other identity contains a difference. So using 4x as our a and 9x as our b, we go ahead and subtract them in the first expression, then we go ahead and add them in the second expression. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Next, we go ahead and factor out the constant 1/2. Then it's just a matter of finding the integral term by term. The integral of the first expression requires a u substitution. This results in the following integral. Then we go ahead and find the integral of the second expression. This one also requires a u substitution. Finding the integral results in the following expression. Having found the integral of each term, we go ahead and add the constant c. The final step is to distribute the constant 1/2. Doing that, we obtain the final answer equal to sine of 5x over 10 plus sine of 13x over 26 plus c. Make sure you identify the type of product that you are face to face with. This way, you can use the correct product to sum identity to find the integral. Alright, let's end the video with the final example. Find the integral of sine of pi x times cosine of 3 pi x dx. Alright, here we have a product of sine and cosine, each having a degree of 1. They also contain distinct arguments. This means that we need to use a product to sum identity. We need to use the identity that contains sine and cosine. So we make use of the following identity. Using pi x as our a, and 3 pi x as our b, we go ahead and rewrite this expression into sums of sines. For the first expression, we go ahead and subtract the angles. And for the second expression, we go ahead and add the angles. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Then we go ahead and factor out the constant 1/2. Now that we have sums of sines, we go ahead and take the integral of each expression. The integral of the first expression requires a u substitution, which results in the following integral. The second expression also requires a u substitution, and this one results in the following integral. Then we go ahead and include the constant c. The next step is to distribute the constant 1/2. Doing that, we obtain the following. Notice that one of our expressions contains a negative angle inside of the argument. For the most part, we don't want to have negative arguments. We can fix this by remembering that cosine is technically an even function. This means that it possesses the following property. As a consequence, this negative angle results in the same expression as if it were a positive angle. So we might as well rewrite it with a positive argument. A note of caution, this is not the case with sine. Sine is technically an odd function and possesses the following property. Remember, if you still need a list of trigonometric identities, you can go to mathfortress.com and download a trigonometric identities formula sheet in the pre-calculus section. So rewriting the negative argument results in the final expression equal to cosine of 2 pi x over 4 pi minus cosine of 4 pi x over 8 pi plus c. Alright, at this point we've covered pretty much all the possible cases involving products of sine and cosine. In our next video, we will go over special integrals that contain combinations of sine and cosine that do not fit nicely into one of the forms that we have seen so far. Nevertheless, all the techniques that we have learned up to this point can be used to find the integral.